Internet people. Okay. I'm gonna have a different angle, different take here. Let's have a look. 47 days to go. It's a little late in the day, but we are keeping our promise to do this kind of a behind the scenes video for the next 52 days. And so I had a little cold, dealt with it, had a bunch of people come to my house, make a bunch of noise. So now it's nice and quiet, and we can get to the matter at hand. This is our hyperlocal newsletter, Career Spotlight, and we are looking over what happened in, this is now week six. So week six, we're into the end of November, going into December of last year. As you can see here, we're using the three-part story format now. We're not just using a regular, just pulling one of the headlines of the stories as the subject line for the newsletter, email that goes out, as well as the post. So we're doing that. And as always, we have our table of contents so people can see. Jumping right off the bat here is again our engagement post that we'll have here. Who's the best barbecue? Talking about an event that people can learn more about. So we're pulling those in now as part of the content. Two sports stories, a crime story. All right. And there was a murder case that happened. And yes, this downtown park opened, and it's a big deal. And there's another crime story. So that's kind of the formula that we're sticking with. Giving people a little bit of a teaser of what the story is about. If they want to know more about the story, they can go read the full report on that. The same thing with the campus shooting. Guys treated for schizophrenia, mental health. If you want to read the whole story, go ahead. Go ahead and read it. The latest attraction that's coming is really kind of short, to the point, in and out. You can read the whole thing in less than 3 minutes. If you want to know more about how your 6 to 8 million was spent on this project, you can go read the full story. And here is the link to go to our Facebook page where we can get some engagement. Now, again, our whole goal is really not to grow engagement on Facebook. Our goal is to get our readers engaged with our content, and for them to open our email and to be participants in basically making our content more personal to them, or specific to them. So from what we learn on these nominations, we put them back inside the newsletter. So the actual place for action is our newsletter, not our Facebook page. So if you go to Facebook page, you'll see, oh, there's not much engagement on the Facebook page, because now we're not trying to give Zuckerberg more people. We're trying to learn more about our readers. So again, we've got a sports story, we have viral meme, and yeah, so now we're highlighting this event. And again, we're learning how to write these to make them interesting, to get people to click through. These links are not affiliate links. They're just going with no need to make any money off them. Just send people over to where they can buy tickets. And again, the event didn't ask us to sponsor this. I randomly picked this one because I thought it was fun. I liked it. And most likely, I would have shared this with a neighbor or friend anyway. So I'm sharing this with my readers. So that's what we're doing here. That's the logic behind that. The next one, okay, something interesting. Again, we're always switching it up, going back to the single storyline, subject line, just testing it out, seeing how what creates opens and what works. So, just another lifestyle story, something that's interesting that's going on. 50th anniversary and Powerball, so you're putting that together. It's a positive story. There's a crime story, again, two sports stories, and Christmas is coming, so now we're giving people some tips on on gifts to remember. There's lots of blogs and stories about that. So you don't actually have to go and create it all yourself. You can curate some of the best ideas and link people to that kind of stuff. So that's pretty straightforward, very, very easy once you got your rhythm down. Oh, yeah, this is brilliant. This is something new that we discovered in our research. We started putting in high school sports. So we found this website that had high school sports platform that was streaming games. And then we could definitely, we listed the names of the local schools that are in there that we found that you could actually watch some of their football games or any sports that's being streamed there. People can have access to that. So that was something pretty useful. And you'll see that showing up during the football and basketball season. We'll be talking about that. Okay. So that's something new. Same style headline as before. We're doing the same thing here. Crime story, crime story, crime story. Well, if it bleeds, it leads. This is true for lots of news publications. Here is a daycare worker. Well, moms, grandmas, grandparents, these people are going to be concerned about this. Who's doing it? It's in Wake County. Taping kids' mouth, that's a big no-no. Two car wreck, people want to know about that kind of stuff. Fatal stabbing at a high school. Well, okay, these are all things that are people in the community would be engaged in and want to know about. So this is not like we're trying to do some kind of a tabloidy style newspaper. This is actual things that are happening that people are talking about and that they would be interested in. Oh, and here's another new thing. I actually, because of our activity that I've been doing, somebody approached us and shared this video about a drone flying over the new park because the new park has been all rage. And so we were able to get the YouTube link, and we can now show people what the downtown park looks like at night. Part of the excitement to get people to go down to this district and enjoy all the facilities and activities they have downtown. Sports news, and yeah, one thing is interesting. Note, there are no reader polls in this particular newsletter. Something that I ha highly recommend if you have some stories, especially like the downtown park opening. You definitely want to put some kind of reader poll on that kind of story. Oh, this is a very special edition here. Emerson Pauly, this is a story of, I got told about this from my sister who knows this little boy's mom, and he was appearing on a TV show, Master Junior Chef. And she's like, well, I don't know if you would be interested in the story, but have a look. And I did some research on this young guy, and he's been out there doing lots of amazing things, even stand-up comedy and stuff like that. And he's a local kid, a rising star. So we did a story about the rising star. And then my sister forwarded the story to his mom, and she was really thrilled, and she's become a subscriber, and we've been promoting some of his content as well. So he's a content producer on Facebook and other platforms, and we definitely look forward to his short videos and things that he does. And that's also good for your newsletter to kind of showcase. That's the whole point of what we do here. Spotlight, showcase, amplify other people's positive stories. School safety, I can see that being something important. Here, talked about a new appointment in obstetrics. It's interesting, but not necessarily something that I would necessarily bring back into the newsletter, but it was a story that was going around. Two sports stories again, and our engagement on Facebook story. So yeah, we were able to pull in his stand-up routine and then tell a little story of what's going on. And yeah, that was really cool to be able to share that story of his upcoming TV appearance and being in that series and representing Carrie. So that was really good. All right, so Same style of headline here. And again, now we're going with what makes Gary great kind of stuff. So we found a study that recently came out, talked about the great work-life balance that we have. This is epilepsy, more like a medical story, and then how AI is transforming the workplace. So this is more kind of like a work-life balance type theme here. Sports betting, we're still working on that story. And there's another story about esports, which is a different angle. So that's very interesting. Talking about a carry startup. So that's the story again. It was more like a press release that was taken, and we were able to get that information. And yeah, we're getting to the end of the week. There's a Again, some of the things that I would definitely put in here is the reader poll, at least one of them, so people can get used to clicking and used to giving feedback. Because the whole key for our growth of our newsletter and the loyalty that we got for our newsletter is building loyalty is letting people give feedback and then having people feel that they've been heard. So this is something important. Expanding gun rights. Current. So yes, we're not getting into politics, but gun rights is a couple of things that affect a lot of people in North Carolina. And the new laws came into effect, so we're not going into the politics of the laws. We're just letting people know of their rights and whether it's been expanded or been restricted upon, how they feel to respond to it, we leave it up to them. Okay. Another crime story, investigations into landlord, overcharging people $18,000. So that's a story that definitely want to talk about. Here we go into a high school story. Again, this time of the year, winter fall is great. Sports, there's a lot of sports going on. Can definitely pull in more lo local interest by showcasing some of the high school sports that are going on in the area. And there's lots of great content for that. And yeah, there we go back with the tasty trend, giving people a fun recipe. So pretty straightforward. Interestingly, I do know that we're skipped a specialty post, which we started, I believe, the week prior, which was the discovery and travel edition. And in this week we did not do it. Not real sure why I chose not to do that, to be honest. But it's worth noting that you try new things, and once it works, you stick with it no matter what. So. But you have flexibility in the kind of stories that you want to run. And then of course, end of the week, with or if you want to say we start the week, which is on Monday, in our editorial kind of cycle, the way we look at it, it's like Monday is the end of our editorial week, and then we start the whole new cycle on a Tuesday. And that's just my choice. It's by choice because again, a lot of holidays fall on a Monday, and so it was just easier to do real estate on a Monday. If things are closed, if stuff's not happening, if you're not around, if you want to go on vacation, just stick in real estate because it's data that you can get on a Friday afternoon or on a Saturday or something like that, and you can start processing this particular edition. It just gives you that flexibility of time to be able to have this ready to go without having to sacrifice an extra work day for this. So again, we have our sponsored edition, and we same ideas, properties, pretty much. It becomes boring, but you stick with it because yes, after a while you start getting to know these numbers. The numbers are going up, the numbers are going down, and you go check out the properties. We're still maintaining this, oh, what are the median prices in different areas? But again, like I said, in the past video, I got rid of this because it wasn't really adding any extra value for people living in Cary. And no one actually complained that it was gone. So that had to go. And we asked feedback on whether they found it useful. And that's it. That's how we got out of it. But the main thing is that, yeah, getting local people showcase local talent. That was kind of the highlight of what we did here in bringing in high school sports and also getting more reader engagement. That's kind of the summary of that.